Well, that's on, now it's on ultraviolet. Now it's on infrared. And I'll bet you 10 to 1 after 2 minutes after I put this in, it's going to. Oh, that's good. Okay, I just noticed that my camera just reset itself up again. Never did for try to figure out why it does this at times that when I try to videotape it, it sometimes after 40 minutes or something, or 40 or 50 minutes, it just turns itself off and turn itself back on again. It's my little Samsung camera, so. Yeah. Oh, what is this? What's going on here? I guess there were a bunch of scientists, you know, showing their camera. Looking at their camera. Okay. Now, this is what people would like to see. That's ultraviolet, and that's pretty good pictures. That's not, that's just how it looks through a sun through a filtered lens, so people don't, or a heavy filter, so you don't, you know, you can see the sun without burning your eyes out. And the thing's been, I think, I see 2 hours, 15 minutes. That's probably how long this has been going on. Supposed to be scheduled for 6 hours. You know, it's supposed to be a 6 hour show or something like this. And I'm not going to film the entire 6 hours. Two reasons, my batteries don't last that long. Also, when I decided to film this, I just kind of did it at the spur of the moment. I just brought the camera out and started filming.
We're back, and I'm here again with Gary Fujihara, who's done a fantastic job just supporting us, giving us all kinds of great information for the transit. But earlier, before the transit, you sent me an email and mentioned the passing of a very dear friend of the universities and astronomy and Hawaii and everything else. And I just want to give Gary an opportunity to say a few words about Dr. Crow, right?
Yes, thank you, Blair. You know, all of Hawaii Island and much of Hawaii State mourns the loss of a dear friend about a week ago. His name is Dr. Richard Crow, and 26 years ago he co-founded the undergraduate astronomy program here at the University of Hawaii at Hilo, which is growing strong to this day. He's a musician with the Hawaii County Band. He's also a member of the Rotary Club of Hilo Bay, and also a past president. This man has touched a lot of people,
Absolutely.
Blair, and his legacy lives on in the students that are going on in their careers in astronomy. And I just wanted to shout out to Richard, who's watching from up above. You know, thank you for everything you've done.
Well, I tell you, it's been a
He
real
probably
treat. I
has
can
the
attest
best
to this
view.
very briefly. I have very very little experience, but even as I came into the HP where we're staying at the 9,000 foot level, there's a big sign on the wall saying, "We miss you, Dr. Crow." So it's so true. I'm sure you guys will miss him. I wish we'd had a chance to meet him and interview him for the show, but we're so glad to give you this opportunity to share your thoughts about him. I'm sure he will be missed, but his impact will not cease. It will continue to inspire others here atop Mauna Kea, but also at the university. Thanks so much. You're watching NASA Edge.
Okay, well, I didn't want to cancel it right there when they started talking, but when they mentioned this, Mr. Crow had a tribute to him, I figured it would be in bad taste. There's Venus again, right there. Again, this is a view from my home, from the looking. I'm my camera set right at the video at the computer screen at home, watching the Venus transit, or what they call some people say the Venus lunar eclipse, or Venus eclipse, or Venus crossing the sun, whatever they're going to call it, or the Venus transit, whatever. Kind of hard to figure out which direction it's going there. That's so. We're back to infrared. Looks more cool. It looks a little bit. I would say a little bit more cooler that way. Cool that way. Plus, you see a little bit more details of the sun. No, I remember seeing the movie WALL-E, where when he left the Earth on board the spaceship, and he came and he recharged himself on the sun with his little solar batteries. And I noticed the solar in the sun there was kind of like infrared too. In real life, it probably wouldn't have been that way. Well, they probably did it that way because they couldn't really show it that way. It probably looked more. It looks probably more interesting at showing it as an ultraviolet than it would have been as somebody would have probably looked at it and tried to just tone down the light. Okay, that's on that is on ultraviolet again. Okay. See, if an ultraviolet, you can see the sunspots a little bit more clearer than you do an ultraviolet than you do with infrared. And then you can see some of the sunspots when you have the sun filter in place. Oh, wait a minute, what's going on here? 12.
All right, what you're seeing here is a picture of the NASA NEMO team in Florida. They're in mid-mission, taking time out in the MMC to not only monitor the activities going on for NEMO, but also to watch the Venus transit coverage we're providing via Ustream, and in large part because they helped us learn how to do this. So we love the NEMO team. Big shout out.
Okay, I think we're going to end this. I'm going to end this, filming all this, because two reasons. One, this is taking a long time. And two, my batteries are running low, so, well, I would have to recharge my batteries and all that, so. Well, I have extra batteries and stuff and a direct power cable feed, but I think just that. Can't get too much. I can only comment so much and can only find so much stuff on the internet to film on my video camera. Okay, this is the Spaceman 42 channel. You know, that's filmed the Venus transit across the sun, and it probably won't happen for another 117 years. Of course, by that time, I'm sure that space travel will probably be more commonplace than it is, you know, with all, and plus video cameras will probably be replaced with something that was microchips or something, well, probably something completely different, whatever it's going to be, who knows what the future will hold. There's Venus. Those are the sunspots. That's another sunspot. Again, this is a feed from Norway. Okay, this is the Spaceman 42 channel. Signing off from the Venus, from the websites you see at the Venus. Right there, see? You're all watching Norway, yeah. Signing off from now of the Venus Transit 2012 and video from stuff I'm seeing on the internet. Thank you. Have a nice day or a nice week, and wherever you are in the world.